It's a historic mission that began right here on Central Florida's Space Coast. The SLS rocket blasted off from the Kennedy Space Center carrying the Orion spacecraft on November 16th. After weeks in orbit, it's now on its way home and is set to splash down Sunday in the Pacific, marking the end of the Artemis 1 test mission. Questions of our Bureau Chief Scott Heidler walks us through what's expected to happen and what this all means for the Artemis program.
The important Artemis 1 test mission is about to reach one of its most critical moments. Spacecraft Orion's re-entry and splashdown Sunday afternoon at 12:40. When Orion begins to re-enter Earth's atmosphere, it'll be going more than 20,000 miles per hour, speed built up from its lunar journey. A true test for the heat shield, a new design of blocks made with new materials.
They're really going to want to test like whether the gap fillers and things like that between these blocks is going to be able to withstand the 5,000 degree temperatures upon reentry. And so I think that's the big concern, and that's really what they're going to be watching for Sunday.
The splashdown location was moved a few hundred nautical miles south off the Baja, Mexico coast. The original location off San Diego coast had to be shifted because of a cold front and stormy seas. And on reentry, the craft will make what's called a skip maneuver to reduce some of that high velocity.
Instead of just coming down and landing or splashing down straight at the ocean, it's going to do a different type of profile. It's going to start going down and then come up a little bit and then go down and splash on the ocean.
Orion will then return to the Kennedy Space Center in late December, so engineers can take a very close look at the craft after its mission to deep space and back. On the Space Coast, Scott Heidler, West 2 News.
West 2 has been covering Artemis 1 from the beginning. We'll bring you the splashdown live on West 2 when this happens, with coverage from the Kennedy Space Center.